inspiring talks. Our next speaker is Sergi Sergiev. He's head of Data Science Society. Data Science Society is an organization which supports and promotes collaboration between experts in data science sector and has exposure in more than 20 countries, and it's in, and it continues to grow. He will be presenting why and how startups have to be fast using existing business intelligence solutions, give overview of different business intelligence tools, and tell us what is so special about Google Data Studio. So, the
floor is yours. Hello, hello all. My name is Sergi. I will present you, I slightly change it, but keep the main focus on, of this presentation is the startups and how they select the BI tool, which BI tool is proper for them. I will go in details. I have several projects, and for different one we take different decisions. So I hope at the end of the presentation you will learn something, and which I will transfer to you. How it will be, just showing you information about the startups and what's the difference between the normal product development, and also overview of the different BI tool. It's like a glimpse of what we find out and what works best for us. Google Data Studio brief overview and an example of one of the products. So this is me, my experience up to now. I have been I work in a development, then a consultant. Then I was managing 5 teams, then graduated in Austria, MBA. And the last 5 years I started with startups. The first one is not even here, it was for email marketing. The next one is this called Tiki. Tiki is a mobile ticketing platform. We raise investment here. I was in San Francisco, then in UK. At the end I left the team, and now we have 3 or 4 implementation in 4 cities in Bulgaria. The next one is a ShopUp, I will tell you more about it and a little bit more later on, and the Catwing. Something which I'm working the last 4 years is the Data Science Society project. This is a project where we believe that people, especially in this domain, fast-changing domain, can learn and share knowledge among each others. And we are doing a lot of stuff in that area. So is there some of you, if you can raise a hand, have heard about datathons? Yeah, okay, this is relatively new topic for you. It's a hackathon. Hackathon with data. So it is 2 days hackathon with data. What we are organizing, such global datathons. The last one, there were people from more than 20 countries. Now we have our hosts. We have online, and also we have in four locations. One of them is in Austria with We Are Developers. We have Bulgaria, Sofia University. We have Croatia with Algebra and Atomic. And we have India with Pro Learn and Manipal. The difference here, what we see and what strives us to work in that direction, that we all know Kaggle. We all know their data sets, how complex and hard they are. But what we are trying to bridge is when the people graduated, when they finish, when they want to become a data scientist, this is a very good entry point where for 2 or 3 days they can experiment with data, with the mentors and mentorships. So we are starting in less than 10 days, and the registration is closing in 4 days. Do you know these guys? Any of you, just if you have seen them, raise a hand. Ah, Tommy, no. Okay, so I'm surprised these guys are our last winners, and they're from Serbia. Their team was called 7 Bridges, and at that datathon, they were participants from more than 20 countries. They come from here to Bulgaria, and they were real pro professionals. I mean, they work on a case with DNA, and the results were awesome. I mean, I think all the jury voted for them to they're the winners. And something else, if some of you wants to participate, our friends from Data Science Conference, this is a promo code. I think for one or two teams, 5 to 10 people, I'm not quite sure, which the faster wins. Also, if you want physically to participate, you can go in Zagreb or you can come in Sofia. So you have that choice. And stop with lyrics. So now starting with the topic, artificial intelligence and startups. It's according to me, it's a different mindset. I mean, the startups, comparing to the product development, they need to take different decisions. And one of the most important part which I see in the AI, I will not explain what's the machine learning, what's the neural network, what's the data science, where AI is. We believe that AI, it's something which helps automatically based on the data which is around us. And we take this for granted. Normally, and which each initiatives, each idea, so because normally it starts with an idea, people are need to take a decision where they and what they want to focus on. The technology is if they want to embrace particular technology. One of the startups, ShopUp, we decided to go in that path. The other one is the expertise, which is tougher. I mean, normally someone needs to have at least 10 years in a sector, in a particular sector, knows the problem, have already solved this problem, and knows how to deploy that. And the other one is consultancy, which is relevant to students. Where they are young, the best way they have learned, they have passed through different courses, even they attended several datathons, and then they feel comfortable that they can solve every problem on the earth, and they start working on the consultancy projects. And once that decision is taken, then we have three resources limitation. This is my interpretation of the resources from the startup perspective. The first one is time. Time, the startup, the most important for the startup is to be fast. And this is what differentiates them from the other big companies. So small team, people, very small team, like 2 or 3 people, they need to be very fast. They need to gain expertise from somewhere. And something which I put the last one is the money. But I don't not really say that I don't like that part. The money, normally there are wise money if you work with customers. So they are an investment. So I will advise no one goes to investment when they have an idea. Working with your customer, because I know a lot of startups, they raise some small capital, and then everything was spoiled. Everything was ruined because they start feeling comfortable, start thinking what is important for the customer, and then they forget the link with the customer. So this is my interpretation. And then to become concrete, now within the retail, yeah, this is my interpretation for the retail. What kind of solutions we see, and probably based on my experience, if most of you are more experienced, I'll be happy then to advise me to add some bullets here. But what I see for retailers, there are several bullets. On the retailer level, he's more interested about the stores and the employees. And then he wants to go further and see what's the situation with their customers. And what it means their customer, what's their basket, what are the brands which they are buying, what are the multi-categories. This categories terminology is something which is like for the last 20 years. Each product then goes to a different categories because people are buying based on you go to buy water. So this is the category water, for instance. Then there are assortments improvement, price and promotion, in stock. It's a warehouse stuff. And the last one, which we see is the vendors, how they work with different vendors. Just to give you an example, one retailer having between 10 to 15,000 SKUs. For them, it's very hard to manage all this in details. And based on that, we started our ShopUp. It's a platform like 3 years ago. It's like a Google Analytics, but for physical places. Imagine in the malls, in different malls, in different shopping centers, in different retailers. We are providing information where the people are going, how often they are coming, what's their patterns, what is their behavior overall. What we are using, we all have this one. So if it is switch on, it's Bluetooth, or Wi-Fi, or we are using images, these door counters. There are two type of cameras. One is on the front, one is on the top. I mean, with this technology, it's 99.3% accurate. So we have some custom clients in Canada. So here it's a physical part, which one before that was not even captured. And yeah, so we are covering these stores and behavior. And the next project which we are working on covers all the rest, Catwing, where we also only post data. And probably you have seen different diagrams. This is what I see as a startup who wants to be focused on the data. What are the main stages? They can be such improvements. In terms of data sources, it needs to be easy to integrate additional sources, to maintain them, to have a scalable platform. For instance, for one of them, we choose, I will share SAP HANA. And once we onboard our first mall, everything crashes. And then now we are on Amazon. So I think all of us are on Amazon. Don't ask me why we choose SAP HANA. It was a business-driven decision, so yeah. But this is one of the directions. The other one is the data preparation. The data preparation is normally within one mall, we have between 300 to 500 million records. So we need to make something with that. We can't really show for a month what is happening there. So data prep is a very important part. And then I call it the first layer is the analytics of the already prepared data. Then is the next one is the predictive models, where you want to make some forecasting, patterns, enrich data. And then you need to visualize them again on analytics. And the last one is normally the automation, or I call it generating triggers, because the retailers, if we help them be more effective and substitute their time in making some regular decisions, we are on the right track. So it means these triggers can be push notification to a mobile app, it can be to send email to someone, or to send the SMS, or using the API, it means something to be sent somewhere. And based on particular rules, which can be machine learning driven or no matter what. And on this whole part, I will cover about the analytics BI tools, which we choose and why we choose them. You need to be a kind of a ninja, but also need to have a meme, so everyone needs to like you. So the visualization is important, and the time which you spend is also important. So here are the main directions which we focus. It needs, in terms of resources, it needs to be minimal. It means, especially for a startup, the time for implementation, also the time for development, the time for maintaining, and also the costs. Because sometimes it's important. I mean, it's especially for the cost, it really depends on the product. It needs to be easy to add new data set, to be flexible. And something else which we find it's really great is great visualization. So especially for the customers. But again, it depends on the product. If you are focused on visualization is one part. If you are focusing on machine learning and automation is a different part. I mean, sometimes it needs to be on-premise or on-site or a pluggable solution. We identify, probably these are the top 10 which we see. This report server and knowledge, they are community driven. So they have some, you can pay, they are free. I think it is a server, reporting server, but it's the BI, again, open source. All the rest you need to pay something. Everything you need to pay, apart from this one, which is Data Studio Beta, which I'm going to show some demo around it. For the Catwing project, which I mentioned to you, we don't really pay attention on the visualization. So we don't care a lot. It needs to be our in-house. because we are providing automation stuff. We are providing the benefit of substituting someone to take a decision, reviewing more than 1,000 SQs in their performance. So that's why we decided to use Tableau, because it's easy to implement. In terms of resources, it's fast, and it costs something, but we are not so selling this to B2C, it's B2B to bigger customers, so they are able to cover the costs, which are something like $100 or less than $100. With ShopUp, it's a little bit different. We decided to use Data Studio because we already developed front-end. Front-end, we started with, it was SAP proprietary front-end. Then we transfer and we use high charts visualization of JavaScript. And now, based on that, we have our front-end and we need to enrich the reports. So we decided to use Data Studio because it's like a little bit more fancy of Excel. So with each customer, we are spending time what kind of reports we can do. We can show them. Then we are showing on the second customer. And once we decided that these reports are fine, then we are implementing it into our front end. And generally, I think that's it from this point of view. And now I will show you for the Data Studio beta. Before I go to with the demo, should I ask now for a question, or it's like eight minutes demo? Okay. So the demo, I was thinking I can present it now, so I prepared it like an hour ago. Type Google Data Studio, goes there. You can see these are some of the templates. It's like a Google document, owned by me, shared with me, trash. Here they have reports, different kind of reports, data sources, how to add data source and what kind of data source. This Explorer stuff is something new, it's lab. I mean, you can use it, it automatically shows you some data. What else? This is their main page. Here we have a report gallery with some templates. Here I will show you how you can use one of the reports for the World Cup Nations. This is the template. I will show you in our product, but just to give you what is the maximum and how maximum it can be fancy comparing to Excel. So I think it's better than Excel, so that's why we choose it. So for instance, you choose Group C, then you can choose a date. It just shows you here the matches. So yeah, they're explanatory. I don't need to speak a lot here. And something which is very good, video tutorials. I really like them, and probably within one or maximum two, probably within half an hour, you are ready. And you can create your reports. Here they have a lot of data sets which you can add. One of them is the by file, they have limitation up to 100 megabytes. All the rest, we use some of them and Postgre. We normally use both of them, so our database. I'll just show you. You can very easily put the configuration and paste the SQL script, which then generates the data, and it is live. So this is a good advantage which we are using. And now how the reports look like. Just a second. You can choose report, and here there is one report which we created. It's the tool itself. This is how it's visualized. You can easily edit, you can share with someone else. Here are some edit options, view, insert. You have some limitation of the data chart. These are the only one. But again, over there are also shown. Here you have pages, which are pages from here, which you can choose. Some alignments, the resources. You can manage the data sources. Here it shows this is the Postgre, this is the SQL. And each one of them, there are characteristics. you can change their type. Something which works very well is with the time and dates. We all know there are a lot of problems there. It's with drop down and very easy. You can choose day to show you day of week or something in that direction. Here is one of the reports, multiple venue effectiveness. You can choose, this is normally a view for the managers. They have like, here in our example, there are three stores and they need to measure their effectiveness for a particular time. And for the sake of, when I record it, I will show you later on what are the results. Now it takes some time and it's because it's a request on Postgres. So imagine that for this multiple venue, you compare the traffic, how many people are passing by a particular store, and how many of them stop and enter inside, and comparing to the time of the service. I mean, if you enter in one store, you can stay 15 minutes or you can stay 1 minute. If you stay 1 minute, you are a bounce visitor. If you stay more than 15 minutes, you are engaged visitor. So this is going to be shown later on, just to prepare you. And here is the different type of configuration for the fields, which is very intuitive, you know, Google style. And here are the settings. For instance, if we choose visitors new versus loyal, this is something else. We are showing this chart, what is the percentage of people for particular month, for particular store, how many of them are new. Just a second, how many of them have come within the last week, the last month, the last 2 months, or over 2 months. And here is the visualization of their volume. And this one is spend time. And what we can see that the people coming once per week are spending much more time. So you can identify who are their engaged customers. Or even you can go deeper and see the ones who are coming for 2 or 3 days. Here is just to show you how easy it is to create a report. You choose one of the options, drag and drop it, and then put a configuration. For this one, the data is very simple. Shop ID, month, what's the type, how many sessions for a particular day, and what's the average session duration. I mean, I know it's out of context for you what kind of data is there. But just to give you an example that having it, the data, it's very easy and intuitive to visualize it. And very flexible because you can change the date range, you can change the stores. These are our stores. Here we are measuring comparing to stores. Here now we change the dimension. And now we are measuring based on the how frequently they are coming. And it just based on the settings there. Just an example. Okay, so again, these are features. Do you want the data to be aggregated, to average, counted, and such kind of stuff? I mean, comparing to, for the purposes which we were looking for, it is very intuitive. One of my friends in their company, all their reporting goes through that. I mean, they are not using any other, even Tableau, such kind of stuff, so they're using only this. I can't really show the how they organize it, but there is a different dashboard. And here, for instance, cross passerbys. These are something which are the people who are passing by from this store. 16% of them have passed, or 27 for a particular month, have passed through that store, and 10% have passed through the other store. But I was almost at the end. So these are generally, we saw what kind of different reports can be done. And the situation is that probably I was supposed to show you and our front end, just to compare what's the difference between both of them. In general, the Data Studio, which we use, is in beta version. So the disadvantage is that you can't create one layer, one report, and give it to multiple customers because you don't have this user's interface. You can't really change roles and such kind of stuff. It's more like like an Excel in a modern way with a link. You can share who can see it with a complex visibility. The good part is that apart from the Excel, you are sharing like a Google Drive. You can edit it constantly and make changes inside. And yeah, we really find it suitable, especially for some additional requests. And I think that's all. Thank you.
There are several questions, so yeah, I'm gonna read them. How would you define business intelligence tools, and what should they be used for, and what should they not be used for?
Okay, there are a lot of platforms. So the BI tools is a good way to represent data in a way that we are not able to, we don't have the sense and the way to interpret it. So what I see is that the BI tools, the future or this part is that using such complex visualizations which fit into the particular niche, providing relevant insights are very important, and this is what I'm. So the future goes in that direction, providing the details. So.
Thanks. What do you think of Power BI?
Power BI. Why we didn't choose it? Just a second. We have some limitations. First of all, for the startup perspective. Microsoft really help us a lot, so they make several introduction of us to a lot of companies, and which we try to. I remember. Yeah, Linux and Windows. They have problem with that. So if you need to configure Power BI on Windows, you have problems, especially with the PostgreSQL database. And we contacted even someone who was architect, but. At that time, if you are a startup, you can solve something within half an hour, 2 hours, you ignore it. So that was, we just canceled. I mean, we tried with PostgreSQL integration, it was not working. So next, that was, yeah.
There's one question about Data Studio. Is Data Studio free only while in beta? Any ideas about pricing? So the question about the pricing.
About Data Studio.
Yes.
So it is free. I mean, it is free. It has some limitation. It is free up to 15 gigabytes. There, you need to pay for something at a certain. I mean, at one place, at one time. But I think it is done for B2C to a lot of people to use it. So, but I don't see big value of Data Studio to use it for a big volume of data. I mean, if you are using it, a great substitute for Excel. This is my feeling. For something more complex, you need to pay for sure. Yeah, and that's it.
One question. What do you think about ClickSense?
Okay, we don't have enough time to test everything. For some of them, I use, I know all of us probably who are here are analysts and want one task and give them the whole time of the world, and they need to analyze, see, browse top 10, top 100. Something, one of the first approaches which I did and which I learned working with products is ask experts, ask friends. So that's why I can't tell you more about ClickSense, because I know it. It's in top 10 or top 15, but we didn't spend time and I didn't receive any positive signs.
And question about ShopUp, which programming language did you use for creating it?
So we use, it depends from the backend on, okay, you don't have this. The data coming, and there is a script of Go, then Python, then some Java, and visualization is JavaScript. So if that's, yeah, that's all.
Is it possible to add plain CSV files as a constant data feed? I guess it's about data.
Can you repeat? Is it possible to add plain CSV? Something to add on the previous question.
Yeah.
Because we are using an embedded devices, we use C for Wi-Fi routers management. So just, yeah, because it's important, we are sniffing the Wi-Fis.
Is it possible to add plain CSV files as a constant data feed? I guess it's about Google Studio.
Yeah, you cannot, I think Excel, you cannot, I mean the delimiter. Google did a good job. It automatically detects. It really helps you. This one, which is in lab, which was the third option, it really helps you putting a data to show some insights which probably you have never think about. So to answer on your question, there are huge amount of data. You can add your Twitter account, your Google account, your YouTube analytics, different kind of analytics, everything in one place. It is very easy. What I see for the marketing guys, if there are some marketing guys, they can very easy put information from their social channels, and this is a good tool for visualization.
If you use Google Studio, do you pre-process data? If you do, where you do it? Mm-hmm. In databases, or do you use some ETL tools?
Okay, so I told you we have a huge amount of data coming into our database. I mentioned about Go, how we are crunching the data. Then we, on a Python, we try to aggregate it, and we put it on a Postgre database. From then, depending on the customer requests, I show you the CSV is something which we made a SQL request and then export it on a Python and use this file. Or the other part is with the Postgres, we just make a SQL request and that's it.
I think that that's all of the questions and we're on time, so.
Okay, any questions from
any
the audience?
Any more questions?
Yeah. So this, no, we didn't, so probably I need to repeat the question. So did we use a stream?
Stream sets, it's previously known as a catalog.
Ah, stream sets, no, we didn't use, yeah.
Ah,
okay, so there is, okay, next time you will be one of the first people who I will ask for such, okay. Okay, so there is open source stream sets too, but is it, is it a good analytics that we told?
Depends what kind of data you are analyzing volumes and how you put the backend. So if you put some kind of wallop in the background, like on the big data side, it will crunch petabytes of the data in subset.
Okay, so there is a good solution. Yeah. Okay, I can observe it. But now we are on our next stage, so yeah, thanks. Okay, thank you again.